John Jakes. Before the Civil War, Northerner George Hazard and Southerner Ori Main met as cadets at West Point. They and their families became lifelong friends, but they made an enemy of the evil and sadistic Elkanah Bent. Bent also came to hate Ori's young cousin, Charles Main, who served under him. George married Constance Flynn, while Ori fell in love with and married Madeleine Fabre. The two families remained close until the Civil War divided them. George and Ori fought on opposite sides, both rising to the rank of general, while secretly maintaining their friendship.
Maybe it's up to us, Ori, to start healing the wounds of this nation.
Charles Main served the Confederacy as a scout behind enemy lines. Elkanah Bent spent the war smuggling black market food and arms into the South, while having an affair with Ori's cunning sister, Ashton. She was jealous of her brother and hated his wife, Madeleine. Toward the war's end, Ori and Charles destroyed all of Bent and Ashton's evil plans, and Bent was killed. Now the war is over, and Mont Royal has been burned to the ground by renegades. Ori and Madeleine have lost everything and are staying at a wealthy friend's home in Richmond while trying to find food for the hungry all across the defeated South. Now, Ashton and Bent, alive through some bitter quirk of fate, come to seek Ori out.
Stop. Right here.
Each with a different plan in mind.
Well, look at what we have here. My good old friend, Ori Main. Waited a long time for this.
Now, you be careful. Remember the plan, Al.
I couldn't possibly bargain money out of Ori. Him being angry at me and all, but I'm just sure that you could do such a nice job of it.
Now, don't you worry your pretty little feet about that. It's gonna be business, pure and simple. Your brother wants to feed the South, seeing as how our great Yankee conquerors can't afford to be bothered with such trivialities. I'm the man he has to deal with. He thinks I have what he needs. We'll prevail.
Now, I know where you're going to be, and I'm going to meet you there. However, I'd like to have a few words with Madeleine first. So now you go on and do the best that you can.
It's just what I'm going to do.
Ashton, to you, Jane.
I'll get Madeleine.
Uppity. Far too uppity.
I could scarcely believe it when Jane told me. Why, yes, of course. Those niggers do tell strange tales, don't they? What are you doing here?
Playing. Clean, I believe they call it.
Mr. Main never did show me proper respect. He ruined my reputation with lies and slander. I'll see him in hell before I deal with him.
Mr. Bent, Miss Ashton.
Shut your mouth!
Stop. Right here.
Hold.
Get out of here.
Yes, sir.
Look, let's go. Get out!
Yeah.
Over, mate. I paid you back for your arrogance. Now I'm gonna take care of your good friend, George Hazard, and your precious cousin, Charlie Mayne. Charlie ever tell you what he did to me down in Texas way? And you. You crippled me, just like yourself. You thought you burned me all up, but you just got a piece of me. See what you did to me? Here. Here!
I intend to take back everything that you and Ori have taken from me.
Oh, we've done no-
Your sir. Home, the land, Mount Royal, all of it back.
Ashton, you can't do that.
I can't. But of course I can. And I will. And I will use your little secret as the key to it all.
I'm going to bring you and my brother down so hard you're going to think that the great horned gods of Hades has descended upon you.
Ashton, please. So, my dear Madeline, my advice to you is enjoy what you have while you still have it.
Tell me you're gonna act the grieving sister now.
What in God's name have you done, you fool?
I've righted a grievous wrong.
But where's the money? It was supposed to just be about the money.
Money? What the hell is money? I never intended to do business with your brother. And he never would have dealt with me with his antiquated sense of honor. And now, he's dead.
What about me?
You. I don't need you to do what I'm gonna do. I never needed you.
George, you know, dwelling on dark memories creates a darkened heart.
I guess Ori's death has brought back some memories too recent to bury. I had to search for this.
Oh, that old half dollar that you and Ori split so many years ago.
We each kept a half and pledged to mend it together someday. And now that day'll never come.
Oh, darling, I know you miss him terribly.
I can't believe he's gone. My God, Constance, he survived it all, the wars, the wounds, only to have some coward knife him dead. Where's the sense in that?
Poor Madeline and the baby must be suffering so.
Yes.
Things are so grim in the South right now, and she's all alone now.
I know.
Have you thought about going there?
Yes, I have, but...
I'm sure it would be a great comfort to her, George. And perhaps it would help ease the pain that you're suffering.
The foundries and the ironworks do well under Mr. Quinlan. We're more than comfortable. George, I know you. I trust you and your love. Go to Mount Royal. Help ease the pain and suffering there. Ori would have done the same for you.
St. Louis, next stop, 2 hours. St. Louis.
Porter, some help, please.
May I be of assistance, ma'am? Charles Maine.
Gallen. Captain, Lieutenant?
Private. New to the cavalry.
Truly? I do not have a mind for uniforms. But your manner is most deceptively genteel.
Well, I'm a Southerner, ma'am. Manners count a great deal down there. You'll allow me. You know Trump's Playhouse?
Yes.
Take the lady there.
Yes.
If you please. You're an actress?
I am indeed. You know the theater?
I've seen Edwin Booth, that's about it.
You will hear of Willa Parker. And perhaps come to watch. Driver.
Squad on my command. You'll mount and move into formation. Squad, prepare to mount. Squad, mount.
Corporal May.
Squad, rest.
I see progress with recruits, Corporal. Not much, but progress. Give these horses a rest before they get confused and go wild.
Yes, sir, right away.
Squad dismissed!
Major Chagrou, I know that Corporal Major. He was at West Point, sir, and graduates of the point who fought for the South should be rightfully excluded from the amnesty.
Perhaps, Captain. But he's in my unit now, and Corporal Major...
His name is Maine, sir, Charles Maine. He was an underclassman at the point, and I had to put him on report several times for actions bordering on insubordination.
As far as I'm concerned, Corporal Charles May is one of the best damn horse trainers I've ever seen. Including me, and I'm pretty good. You leave him be, Captain. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, sir.
Be the tally of my love to her! Plead what I will be, not what I have been. Not my deserts, but what I will deserve. Now, die!
Shall I be tempted of the devil thus?
And is this Elizabeth come to torment Richard?
Yes, I'm Willa Parker, Mr. Trump. Eddie Booth wrote to you on my behalf.
Oh, yes, I've heard of him. He thinks he's great, but he's really quite second rate. His brother was quite a marksman, though, particularly at close range. I've never heard of you, my dear.
I've played Portia and Beatrice
Can
and
you
Elizabeth.
Do arithmetic?
Arithmetic?
I don't need an actress. I need someone to manage the books before I go bankrupt. I also need someone to keep me sober until after the performances.
But I'm an actress.
Of course, and I'm a server as a church warden, Santa.
Mr. Booth told me that if I arrived...
Oh, blast, mister.
Mr.
talents, that you are bright and clever.
Then you can use me.
As I said before, I need a caretaker. I'm the star and the person people pay money to see. Take care of me, and I'll try to fit you into some rather minor role in time.
No.
No. What do you want, child?
I will keep your books for you. I will tuck you into bed when you fall into your cups, but I want good roles.
By God, everyone thinks they can act. Very well. We'll give you a try. Off.
I am not a servant. I will, however, see you 1 hour before curtain. Sober.
By God.
Madeline? Madeline, somebody's coming.
Your brother-in-law.
Welcome to the new Mount Royal, Cooper. This is your nephew, Ori. What brings you here?
Passing by. Thought I'd pay my respects.
And survey my home.
I do hold the mortgage, you know.
You look thirsty. Come and have some water.
I'm returning from Columbia. I had to sign a damnable loyalty oath to the Yankees.
To the victor goes the honor and the spoils.
A loyalty oath. How can I be loyal to the people who destroyed all that I love?
But you signed it.
I didn't have much choice, you know. But then we all have to survive, don't we? You've been busy. Clever.
We've worked the garden, and the vegetable crop has been very good to us.
And how do you plan to pay the negress?
With shares from the harvest.
Have you lost your mind?
Not in the least. If Mount Royal is to thrive again, then that is gonna take new thinking.
For your sake, or little Ori's sake, I do hope this works. But mark it well, you miss one payment on that mortgage, and you'll be out, lock, stock, and barrel, and on the road with your negroes.
Ori wouldn't have wanted that. That's why he gave you the paper regarding the land.
Ori is gone. Believe me, I do hope you succeed. I want that for the sake of the family. I do hope you understand the depths of my sincerity, madam.
I never misdoubted it.
Good day, my dear, and good luck to you.
That man don't much like the change that's going on around here.
Change comes harder for some people, Jane.
Got one ticket, front row center, please.
Hello. Private.
It's Corporal.
Excuse me.
Uh-huh.
Anything else?
Dinner with you this evening after the show.
I'd love to.
to get it.
Well, well, now, the illustrious Mr. Maine.
Well, I've come a piece. I could use a drink.
Well, sir, you must have come by Mount Royal. Your sister-in-law couldn't give you a drink?
Water is one thing.
Well, sir, you step right in. Fancy doings up in Mount Royal.
Nothing fancy about a few fields of crops.
No, I'm talking about the school. The Negra School. Madeline May's been bartering all over the country for lumber and hardware. Yeah. She's gonna educate her colored folk so they can be as good as you and me. Ain't that something?
You can't be serious.
Oh, but I am. I mean, it's worded all over the country. Well, this is nice, isn't it? Yeah. Now, those creatures, they have grand ideas, poor things. It's the Yankees. Yankees made them believe that they could be good as or better than us. But then you and me, we know that never can be. Of course, Miss Madeline Maine would have other thoughts on the matter. You ever hear of a word, Ku Klux? It's a Greek word. It means circle.
I heard of the Klan.
Yeah, well, we have ourselves a branch right here. You know, you ought to come around once in a while. We could use a man of breeding like yourself.
Not interested.
Well, you might be. And right soon, Mr. Cooper Maine. The war may be lost, but the cause ain't. Niggers and leaguers, get out of the way. We're born of the night and vanished by day. No nations have we but the flesh of a man. And love niggers best, the Ku Klux Klan.
But for the Bureau of Education,
I never dreamed we'd be so blessed and find a teacher this quickly, Miss Chaffee.
I must warn you, Mrs. Maine, I was an abolitionist before the war. Does that disturb you?
Before the war? It might have. It wouldn't disturb Jane in the least then or now, would it, Jane?
No. Never would. Now, don't go thinking Madeline Maine is wrong-minded either. During the war, she spent herself feeding, clothing, and sheltering hundreds of us. Worked herself to the bone.
The men who are building it? They were once slaves at Mont Royal, but now they have their own parcels of land, and they will share in the crops.
Isaac Kano supervises. A fine man.
You'll be seeing him frequently if Jane has anything to say about it.
I shall require a platform for my table at that end. And I want windows large as possible so the students may enjoy the full use of good light. Agreed?
Agreed. Ah, then you accept.
With enthusiasm.
You sent for me, Mrs.?
Yes, I think I did. Try this on.
Oh, no,
ma'am. Please. This belonged to my late husband, Isaac. And now I want you to have it.
Oh, no, ma'am.
No, please. You can wear it on your wedding day. You're still planning on having a wedding, aren't you?
We're not hopping over some broomstick like in the old days.
Oh, yes, ma'am. We having us one fine wedding. With a real preacher and everything. And, we want you to be there with us, ma'am.
Isaac, will you stop calling me
Ma'am and Mrs., those days are long gone.
Yes, I'm... Madeline, you make me feel so fine and proud. Madeline.
We can't thank you nearly enough.
You don't have to. You already have.
Miss Main, you're no longer welcome in this Christian house of worship. Not anymore.
I beg your pardon, Rip?
Well, colors can't worship in God's house no more. I'm talking about you, Mrs. Dark.
Excuse me?
See, I seen that daguerreotype photograph of your grandma, and, see, it may be long gone, but I seen it. So have others. Cooper May knows it too, ain't that right, Cooper?
Shut your mouth, Geddes. Shut your damn mouth.
Boy, don't you go damning me on Sunday. Now, it is a fact that Mrs. Main is 1/8 Negra. So now go on, Mrs. Dark. Get on out of here now.
I will return for you after the service is over, Prudence.
No, you won't. There is no Christian God blessing this house of abomination.
You filled Geddes. You shame me.
Boy, you better get a grip on yourself. Because there ain't no place for honor in a world gone mad with defeat. There is only death and destruction and the hope that we can get things right again for ourselves. And I know you feel just like we do, don't you? Don't you now? Now, I ain't about to fight you, but I will offer you my hand in friendship on behalf of the brethren here. See? There ain't no chivalry left in the South.
Cooper, come with us.
I do hope we'll be welcome here, Mrs. May.
Every rung goes higher, higher. Every rung goes higher, higher. Every rung goes higher.
Miss Madeline, come on in here. Come on now. Look here, y'all move on down now. Let them come in here and sit down. Come on now, watch yourself. Praise the Lord. Yeah.
We are lying, Jacob's ladder. We are lying, Jacob's ladder. We are lying, Jacob's ladder. Soldiers of the cross.
Thank you.
afternoon, sir.
Madeline?
George. George.
Look at you. You're more lovely than ever.
Oh, filthy, dirty.
Well, even so, all the more beautiful.
Where's Constance?
She's at home in Lehigh Station with the children. I cabled I was coming. Didn't you get it?
Oh, cabled? It's probably still in Charleston waiting delivery. Only bad news travels swiftly, I'm afraid.
Madeline, I can't tell you how sorry I am about Ori's death.
Murder. Ori was murdered, George. But life at Mont Royal goes on. And there is so much to do. It eases the pain. Let's get you a drink of health. It's good to see you.
I know I wouldn't be alive today if Ori and Charlie hadn't broken me out of that Confederate prison. How is Charlie? Have you heard from him?
Not in some time. He headed west, that's all I know. His son, Gustav, he's with some good people in Chicago.
And Ori's killer. What do you know about him?
What law remains in the South, George, is in the form of troops of occupation, night riding vigilance committees. No one knows the identity of Ori's killer. No one.
How long has this man been here?
Weeks. He was fished out of the river, ranting and raving, so we keep him restrained. He's developed some sort of brain fever.
Well, sir, how do you feel today?
Captain. I've achieved the rank of captain.
Captain what?
I don't remember my name. I remember the once great and sovereign state of Georgia. I remember West Point, where my superiors compared my tactical maneuvers to Napoleon's.
Captain.
Jefferson Davis. Jefferson Davis had not failed to recognize my abilities, the South would not be suffering its humiliation at the hands of the North. I wish to be released from this institution, sir. An honorable history of service with the South.
Seems quite lucid to me.
Oh, but sir.
Release him immediately. We need the bed space for truly sick men.
One by four equals four. Now pay attention. One by seven equals
seven.
Now repeat after me.
One by seven equals seven.
Good. Now we'll go right on to the threes.
Three by two equals six.
Good.
Three by three equals nine.
Good.
Everything was built right here. The wood was salvaged from the old house, and then it was cut by hand and finished much the same way. The schoolhouse as well.
They did a fine job. But surely it would have been cheaper to have the lumber cut by a local mill.
There is no such thing, George. Sherman's troops laid waste to everything they got their hands on. Isaac Kano and the other men from the plantation did the work.
Forgive me for asking, but how much did it cost?
Mr. Hazard, how very rude of you.
Miss Chaffee, Ori Main was my best friend. I come down here and I find his widow laboring in the fields like a common farmhand. I see her table is spread with an absence of meat or poultry, and I see her hands are rubbed raw. Forgive me, ladies. Would you indulge us with a few moments of privacy?
Keep going to James.
I don't intend to be rude, Madeline, but I do speak directly. How much are you in debt?
There is no debt, George.
We live quite simply off the land. And though meat is rare, I think the food is quite good, as your empty plate attests.
Madeline, I can help.
Please accept it for the sake of our friendship and what's gone between our families.
George, I know you mean well with your offer. But if Mont Royal is to survive, it must do so under my hand. Charity will just tarnish that effort. Don't you see?
I want to speak to Cooper.
Cooper? He hates Northerners. I'm afraid the war has taken its toll on his pride. He won't see you.
But he's a businessman, Madeline. He'll see me. I know how you feel about charity, but I've got a better idea. A partnership.
Partnership?
I want to build a sawmill right here in Mont Royal for you to manage. Imagine it, the only mill for miles around right here where the logs can be floated down the river. Now the South needs rebuilding, and you can aid that as well as yourself. Madeline, what do you say?
I have nothing to offer in return.
Do you know what this is?
Yes. Ori told me I have the other half.
Then let's make it whole and start mending our lives. This will be our contract.
Mr. Hazard, sir, I do believe we have ourselves a deal.
Very cold.
You're not cold. You're warm and alive.
Well, so it would seem, wouldn't it?
Can I ask you another question?
Well, I imagine you're going to ask it anyway, so why don't you just go ahead?
Why stay in the Army?
There's nothing left for me in the South anymore. Out west, there's a whole country to be found. And there's a need for soldiers with experience.
Fighting Indians.
No, I don't want to fight anyone unless they pick a fight with me. It's just what I do.
I think there's better in you, Charlie.
Well, so have others, and time's proved them wrong.
Times change.
You don't give up easy, do you?
Thank you. you ever been in love?
It sounds like one of those questions that leads into a longer discussion.
No. Answer me.
Yes, I have been.
Who was she?
That was a long time ago.
I think I could love you, Charles Mayne.
Back soon. He expects us to be done.
All right.
Yeah. Here you go. Don't pull me in here.
I got another one out back.
This is not charity, Madeline. It's the same deal I was going to offer Cooper, but we can do it without him. Now, in a year, you'll own all the machinery, and we'll split the profits 60% to you, 40% to me.
50-50.
Deal, but with one condition.
Hazard Iron builds a steam engine.
Business and industry, Madeline.
I paid for fun. Now, lady, you ain't it. Could have had better from a dead cat.
If you want fun, take a bath next time.
Well, if I have to bathe, I'd rather do it to myself.
Well, then, do it! Told you to take a bath!
Oh, excuse me. I paid for the whole night.
Wow, how cute and ambitious.
But I don't really require the usual.
I don't do the unusual. Unless, of course, you pay me, not Rosa, then it's double.
Well, that's fine.
Would you like me in a nightgown or bare?
A nightgown would be fine.
I'll get some clean sheets.
See, I sell pianos.
Oh, I'm not in the market.
I sell Hochstein pianos to church elders, and I'm one tuckered man. I just need a little cuddling and a good night's sleep. And people call me Fen. I don't much favor the rest.
Well, as long as you don't bring a piano to the bed, you can have as much sleep and cuddling as you'd like.
Madame Rosa says you're a lady of quality.
Why, yes. Yes, I am.
I'm sorry you've fallen on hard times.
And you, my dear sir, sell pianos. We'll take money however we can get it.
Oh, yes, of course. Quite. Is that your home?
Yes. It's the most beautiful place on earth. And someday soon, I'm going to return and claim it for my own.
Well, perhaps I can be of service in that endeavor.
However, I should tell you that the last person who tried to help me died a most unfortunate death. Let me help you with this.
Yes.
I have seen so much injustice, and it only gets worse. It's why I feel so strongly about the Negroes and the Indians.
No, you've seen city life, but you've read about injustice, and there's a world of difference.
I don't understand. How can you save one and fight all the rest?
I don't want to fight any of them, Will. I'm a soldier. That's what I do.
But why do you have to fight? See, the Cheyenne, the Comanche, they have a reason. They're fighting to protect their way of life. How would you feel if someone was trying to destroy your way of life?
Well, it already was, and I didn't much care for it.
When will you be back?
Excuse me, gentlemen. Whiskey.
Will I see you again?
Yes.
pardon, ma'am, but I mean no insult to you or your beauty. Not so for you, Johnny Reb.
Go away, Venable.
Captain Venable to you.
Only on the parade ground. Go away, Venable.
The man who promoted you to Sergeant Main may have forgotten the war, but I haven't. I have power over you and always will in this man's army. If you want to speak about power, let's go outside right now. You pay, Sergeant.
May I take your order?
No, that'll be all. If you don't mind, I believe I've lost my appetite. Of mine, Brigadier and his wife take care of him for me up north. I didn't know how to explain to you.
What else haven't you told me? Am I just your kept woman? Does your wife know about your actress
whore? I don't have a wife. Willa, you, you once asked me if I was ever in love. Her name is Augusta. We're gonna be married during the war. She was killed in Virginia. She left me a son.
How old is he? Name?
Gus. Well, I swore I'd never let myself feel this way again.
Do you?
I don't know.
Charlie?
Say now, Maine.
Well, it looks like you got me outnumbered, but then again, that'd be your way, wouldn't it, Venable? Boys.
Better odds than most raped and murdered women had in Kentucky.
Oh, I wouldn't know. I've never raped and murdered anybody myself.
Guerrillas from your army killed my mother, then raped and murdered my sister. Display of Southern chivalry, no doubt. Take this son of a bitch.
Jim, my boy, you stay here. You'll be all right.
But Uncle Dal.
Shh. Be quiet. Shh. We'll have some fun.
Okay.
You stay.
Hold it! All right, Lieutenant. Drop that pig in your hand before I put a hole in your cap. I don't know what this is about. Say 4-1 don't seem fair. So you better get. Come on, get!
Oh,
kick in the head feels right poorly, Captain. You aim to make that discovery? No? Well, crawl out of here like the lizard you are on all fours. Go on, go on. Yes, Sergeant? Yes, soldier boy.
Will it be, friend? Whiskey?
Yeah.
And this one. How much for this one?
She's the best one we got. $2. And I tell you this, you'll have a good time.
Excuse me, Lewis, but, well, you seem to have forgotten that I'm spoken for. I'm Willa Fenway's girl now.
Well, I don't see Fenway here now. Do you, Rosa?
El Fenway no está, mijita.
She says she's Fenway's girl.
El Fenway no está aquí.
No, Rosa, no.
Upstairs. She's spoken for. Say hello to Mr. Fenway. Fenway's girl.
Ay, como
say hello to Fenway.
Can you make a piano?
Hello, Fen might be nice. Make a piano? Well, I'm a drummer when it comes to timbre, tone, and action, but I know men who can.
We're gonna make Fenway pianos. We're gonna sell them to every sporting house and saloon this side of Chicago. I'm through with trying to get Mountain Boyle back from the position I've been in lately.
Well, it's gonna take capital.
It's here, under Rosa's desk. Every other day she takes money to the bank, and she brings back gold, and she puts it in a hole underneath her desk.
That's one crazy notion.
It's gonna take a pair of us. We're gonna have to move that desk, and we're gonna have to get that gold out. But we are gonna do it. I'm gonna need some horse, I'm gonna need a gun.
Well, I don't have a gun.
Well, then get one.
Excuse me. Excuse me. I'm trying to locate a General George Hazen. I'm promised a position at the Ironworks Foundry.
General's away for the time being, and the Foundry's not hiring.
Now, wait a minute here. George and I got to know each other at the Point. We were good friends, and he promised to hire me after the war. He swore to me.
Well, if the General promised, when he returns, no doubt he'll see you employed. He always keeps his word.
As do I.
A fine quality. Well, meanwhile, you don't mind swamping out the station, running messages for the telegrapher. You can work here until General Hazard comes back.
That'd be all right.
He could even bunk down here in the baggage room. And your name is?
Ben. Ben Ellis.
You took a hell of a beating. You got more purple on you than a side of bad beef.
How long have I been out?
4 days. What's your name, soldier?
Charles Main.
I'm Adolphus O. Jackson.
Where are we?
We're western in Missouri. We're heading wester. There we go.
What the hell is that?
Oh, it's just little herbs and buffalo brains. It's a good salve. Brings down the swelling. Well, put it on yourself where it hurts. You know, them fellers that was beating on you, they was determined to finish you, but I run them off.
I guess I owe you for that.
What was it about?
It's an old grudge.
Must be. They charged you with desertion the next day, so I pulled you out of there. If you go back now, they'll jail you or shoot you. And if the Army don't, your soldier friends will finish that job. So you can stick with us if you like. We're the Jackson Trading Company. This is my brother's boy, Jim.
Hi.
He's a little touched in the head, but he's a good lad. Well, hell, I'm going level with you. I pulled you out of that fight because I need a man to cover my back that can shoot. Now, Jim here, he tries, but he's the one who needs caring for. We trade with the Arapaho and the Cheyenne. There's considerable profit in it, too. And I'll give you 20%. And if you prove out, I'll make you a full partner.
Presuming you need a partner, you don't mind me asking what happened to your last one, do you?
I ain't gonna lie to you. I lost old Dean on the last trip. He grabbed a Cheyenne woman who had a husband, and they carved him up. It's sweet country out there. They got plenty of the fattest maidens you ever seen that ain't married. I get along with the Cheyenne because I admire them and I respect them. What do you say?
Well, under the circumstances, it looks like you've got yourself a partner.
All right, Sergeant. Can you shake? Yeah. Got the boy working. That's good. I never thought he'd listen to anyone but me. How'd you do that?
It wasn't hard. I have a boy myself. This takes patience.
Speaking of that, let's load up and move out. Want to catch the Cheyenne before they go into hiding for the season or making war. Gonna learn you the Cheyenne, Charlie. Learn you well so you can keep your hair. That's it, Jim. You're doing good.
Thanks, Uncle Doc.
Let's roll it tight. Come on, let's roll it tight. Here. Here we go. Yeah.
Sam? Sam? Sam, I'm back.
And you return loudly as a tempest. Find what's his name? Well, there is no shortage of prodigals in this world, my dear, nor is there a shortage of eager young men.
You're drunk.
Happily so.
I've been gone for only one day.
Didn't take that long to get drunk, roaring drunk.
Where are the receipts?
I don't know.
Did you give a performance?
I can't quite recall. No. We'll find you another soldier boy. If you wish.
Duncan?
Yes.
I'm Willa Parker. I wrote to you.
Oh, it's Maureen, dear. Please come in.
The Army calls him a deserter, but he had just received a promotion. All he said in his letter to me was that the Army wasn't working out and he was heading west.
Do you know about his son? Well, Charlie writes to him, and he told Gus about you in his letter. We also received letters, but he didn't say much more than you know already. Something must have gone terribly wrong in Charlie's life. He's not a deserter. He was a fine soldier.
He wrote about me?
And was very flattering, but after meeting you, he clearly was not flattering enough.
I'm in love with him.
Charlie is easy to love and difficult to hold on to. But he is forever loyal to his commitments once they are made. This charge of desertion is very disturbing. My husband, Brigadier Duncan, had just put in for a transfer to St. Louis so that Charlie could be near his child. Hello, sweetheart. This is Charlie's son, Gus.
Hello, Gus. I'm Willa.
You know my papa?
Yeah.
He sent this to me.
Oh, he did?
Are you the beautiful lady that makes my papa happy?
Oh, yes.
You don't say that.
I do hope so.
All right now, take him home.
I never doubted it would.
Now all we need is some business.
Well, don't worry. Once the word gets around, business will come. Believe me. Come, sit with me a while. I got a letter from Constance today. She said that my letter to her revealed a delight that she hadn't seen in me since the war. Or since Gettysburg, to be exact. I fought so long and hard to destroy this place. Isn't it funny that I should feel some peace here at last? It's time I went home, Madeline.
Well, you can come back. Bring Constance and the children.
Yes.
Wire just came in from Mrs. Hazard. Your friend, General Hazard, he's on the Washington train tomorrow night. Now run along and bring his missus the good news.
Horses can't carry all this.
Well, then we'll stash it and come back.
We couldn't spend all this in a lifetime.
But of course we can.
Greed is a true sin.
You lost your mind.
It's better than losing your life. Just grab a little thing. Let's get out of here.
Thank you.
Now there be your Cheyenne, running wolves, man. They're peaceable as Cheyenne go. Running wolf's a real kick if he ain't too liquored up.
You know him, do you?
I've had some good trades. He likes me better than most whites. Yeah, running wolf, he's peaceable for the most part, but watch your step with his women. Hey, hey, hey.
Hey, bitch.
Adolphus, who the hell is that?
Oh, hell, dog soldiers.
Don't do nothing foolish, Charlie. Just listen to me, and when I tell you to do something, for God's sake, do it quick.
I gather this is not Running Wolf.
You gather that up right. This is man ready for war. I call him Scar. I reckon you can see why. Son of a bitch. He's always messing up my business dealings.
Does this happen often?
It does. It does.
Narcista. Narcista. Narcista.
Sieh, wo sie huscht. Ist der Nacht.
They're funny. He says he's going to lift our hair.
And now what?
Well, we're going to get down and walk around like we own the place. Just listen to me, Charlie, and take good care of Jim. Listen, Charles, grab Jim's hand. Can you run?
Run, yeah, I can run.
Well, Jim can't run much, so you're gonna have to drag him.
And where am I dragging him to?
Just follow me. Are you ready?
No.
Well, ready or not, here it goes.
Safe now. You won't leave your weapons here. This is just fine. Running in here, that's well, real good. I don't suppose you figured those guys know how to get
in
one of their own
cities
with three white guys in there, huh?
If a thief was running from the law, he could go into a church,
go
and
into
they gave him
church.
Sanctuary.
That's fine. Well, this isn't exactly a church, is it?
Well, of course it is. This is a medicine lodge, same as a church to the Cheyenne. Of course, once we walk out that door, they'll skin us alive and feed us to the fish. He says the chief, Running Wolf, will come here tomorrow and that we're safe till then and he'll give his verdict. He also says that I shouldn't have grabbed Scar's breech clout and humiliated him.
Tell him good advice always comes late, doesn't it?
Well, at least I bought her some time, didn't I? You saved us from man ready for war, and I thank you.
Dark soldiers, go. Man ready for war, go. Hunt buffalo.
I truly thank you, Running Wolf.
Go, Jackson, go fast.
All right, Charlie, watch my back.
Yeah, and who's gonna watch mine?
Well, just trust in the Lord, my boy, and the goodness of Running Wolf. Let's go.
Yeah.
Well, now, I'm about to give up on you. But you made it just in time. Captain? Captain, this here is one of our quality folk, Mr. Cooper Mayne. Captain Jolly comes all the way to us under direct orders from Nathan Bedford Forrest. You come to join our happy band of brethren, Mr. Mayne?
Let's say I'm interested.
All the way from Charleston? I say that's more than interest. Now, please dismount, sir. I don't much fancy speaking up to a man who's merely interested.
Cooper's a good man, Captain.
Is that right? You a good man, Mr. Cooper? You're going to have to prove that to me.
I'm not in the habit of proving myself.
Well, get the habit. Mr. Mayne, you got a mess of difficulties here in the Carolinas. You got a nigger school underway, and the uppity ones are having a convention. They're conspiring how to take over your businesses and your private lives. Pretty soon, they're going to be marrying your sons and daughters.
Never
happened. It's happening in Virginia and Maryland and all over the North. Try that on for size, Mr. Mayne.
I don't have to hide my face to show my feelings.
No, Cooper. It ain't about hiding.
See? Of course not. See, they superstitious.
It's superstitious.
Right.
And we just gonna scare them a bit. Mr. Mayne, since you are the newcomer, you're gonna have the honor of lighting the fire. Take it. This way, sir. Go on, Mr. Mayne, light it.
Gonna be done, honey.
Do we have to wait to get married?
Well, I reckon not. Titus is willing to stand as witness for God for me.
Madeline will do the same for me.
Miss Madeline?
Madeline. Now, you still think the old way, Isaac. But she's my friend.
Yeah, but she white. Sorta.
And you worked alongside General George Hazard, and you shook his hand and hugged, and you liked it.
That was different. Old George.
Isaac, a fire.
That ain't no fire. You go get Miss Madeline and the teacher. And don't you let nobody see you. There ain't no fire. That's the devil coming down the road. And you go on. Go on. Get.
Look!
Either you close down that nigger spool, or we're gonna close it down by fire. Tonight.
Stay down.
Geddes, that hood doesn't hide your voice, and Cooper, who wouldn't know that horse of yours?
Close the school, Madeline, please. We'll leave you in peace.
You want to burn me down, then go ahead. But may the curse of Jesus be on all your heads.
Madeline.
All of you.
You can't talk with no nigger. Let's do it!
Come on, brother, let's roll! This way, come on, let's move it!
You all get ready for the devil.
Knock them boys out of the way, knock them down!
I'll be waiting up for him.
You don't know me, do you? Maybe the name's familiar. Elkanah Bent. I'm an old friend of your husband's, and all remains. We were up at West Point together. Those boys used to have a pet name for me. Butcher. Butcher Bent.
I'm sure it was something foolish from youth.
Now you listen here, little cow. Your husband and his friends injured me. They ruined my reputation at West Point. They conspired to rob me of a military career. Now you will answer all my questions. Or your husband, who is on his way home as we speak, will die as soon as he steps his foot through the front door. Where are your children?
They're not here. They're at Borden's Call.
Good. What about Charlie Main? Where's Charlie?
He
he's out west somewhere. We only hear of him through a Brigadier Duncan. I don't know.
He got a wife? Charlie got a wife? He got something. Child. He got a child. Children. They present such interesting possibilities. Don't you think? Your husband's home.
No.
Second night, Mrs. Hess.